Hi, it's Seta here. In this tutorial, we will learn how to use the box volume in Unity HDRP to apply localized effect in our scene. We will cover how to create a box volume, adjusting its size, and understanding how it works. So, let's get started. For this tutorial, I have prepared a small, simple scene to demonstrate the functionality of box volume. As you can see, a global volume has already been placed in the scene with settings that create a night effect. As the name suggests, the global volume covers the entire scene and all effects added to it will affect every element. This means that if we enter to a building, the exposure and all other effects that create the night effects outside will also apply inside, which doesn't look very good. So if we want to apply for example different post-processing effect in this area, we can use box volume, and then this effect will be visible only when the camera enters in this area. First, let's add a box volume to our scene. To do this, let's go to the hierarchy panel, right click and select volume and then box volume. Of course, it doesn't have to be a box volume, because we can also choose a sphere volume or convex mesh volume, in which we can connect any mesh and create a volume with this shape. However, for this tutorial, I will choose box volume. Let's place this volume in the center of our house, and using a box collider, we can set the boundaries of our box volume. So let's fit it to our building. Now, if we go to the volume settings, we will see several options. The mode is already set to local, meaning that our overlights will only work within the boundaries of the box collider we set earlier. The blend distance determines the distance over which a smooth transition will occur. So, in this case, it will be a transition between all global volume and box volume. The higher the value, the slower the fading between two volumes. The weight controls the intensity of this volume. The lower the value, the less impact the effect have on the scene. Priority allows us to set the importance of the volume over others. So if we have multiple overlapping volumes, the one with the highest priority will be considered first. And here we can create a new profile and add overrides to this volume. At this point, when we move our camera inside and outside, we won't notice any changes. This is because if we have two volumes in the same area and the higher priority volumes do not contain any specific overrides, all overrides is taken from the lower priority volume. So now, if we add, for example, exposure to our box volume, it will override the exposure settings from the global volume. This allows us to add more overrides to our box volume, and because our box volume has a higher priority, they will be taken into account first when the camera will be inside the box collider. It is important to remember that if any effect do not exist in the lower priority volume and we add it here, it will only be used in this box volume. Unless we add another volume with a higher priority within this box volume, in which case it will inherit effects from all lower priority volumes, including the global volumes and the previous box volume. So thanks to box volume, we can create different post-processing variants depending on whether the character will be outside or, for example, in a cave. I hope that this short tutorial has helped you understand how box volume works and what they are used for. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments and I will do my best to answer them all. And until next time, see ya!